Hello YouTube, this is Black Widow 7293. Today I'm not really going to be doing any review. I just wanted to have a little bit of talk about my Rebuildable. And just to give you guys some basic information of what's been going on. For those of you that don't know, the reason why I haven't been like active and having a lot more videos is I was in the process of moving. We're getting stuff unpacked and yada yada yada, more and more excuses. So anyways, I had some issues with Zamplebox and I had to renew my subscription, and that shipped out yesterday, so I should be having a new review or a new unboxing of my March Zamplebox, and that should be coming up by the end of the week. So as far as e-juices left to review, I only have like four left to review, not from Zamplebox, just from my collection. And they are ones I'm not really fond of, so I've been kind of procrastinating with that. And so basically I just want to do a little bit of talking about my Rebuildable. One second. Pagers. Okay. So, what I was just saying. Rebuildables. I had built a coil last night with the organic cotton, and I thought it was really, really good, and I liked it, but I found out that it feels different when you vape with cotton. It does taste a lot cleaner, but you also can't really tell when your juice is getting low, because you still get vapor, even though you're burning cotton instead of wick. So I actually think it was just a bad coil that I had built. It was only a 4-wrap, it was like a 1.6 ohm, and that was a little low for my taste. So I had built a new one today, and I did not use the cotton in this one. I actually used the silica wicks, and I put cotton over top of the coil and around the wicks as well. And this thing is coming up to 1.95 ohms. Which is really nice, and this thing has been throwing out vapor like nothing. So I'm actually vaping Freckled Lemonade by Mount Baker Vapor, 70 VG, 30 H2O mix, 18 milligrams with one extra flavor shot. So I kind of wanted to show you guys what this thing does. Really the only way you're going to get good at building coils is to build coils. You can watch all the videos you want, but until you do it yourself, you're not quite going to understand how tedious and how much finesse you have to use to build these things. Don't let that deter you though from actually getting one and trying it. I've had a lot of people tell me, well, I really don't want to get one, I really don't want to try it, it looks a little too complicated for me. One of two things is going to happen. Well, I should say one of three. One, you're going to build a coil that completely sucks but still works. At least you got it to work. That right there is a success in itself. Two, you're going to build a coil that's shorting out. So that's why you have your ohms tester. And then you just adjust it until it's not shorting out no more. Or three, you're going to build something that is awesome on the first try. And that probably will not happen. So, I mean, my first coil wasn't bad. It was better than the one it came with. So. It actually never burned out, never broke or anything. I just wanted to, I got the cotton, I wanted to try something new. So that's why I built mine. So let me show you how this thing vapes before I continue yapping my trap. And I'm going to be vaping this at 9 watts out of my e-vic. So let's see what it does. Lots of vapor. Let me bump it up a little bit. 9.3. So, this stuff is really, really good. I like the flavor anyways, but I've noticed going between the Pro Tank and this is a lot cleaner flavor. And I wish you could actually see the vapor a little better on camera, because you really can't see it too well. I'm looking at the screen and it's not really showing too much vapor production, which this thing actually pumps it right out. Let me bump it up to 9.5 and we'll see what we get. There we go. So, anyways, I just wanted to show you guys that I'm getting slowly better with rebuilding these, and it does take a lot of patience and time. You just have to apply yourself, and the more you do it, the better you're going to get. Also, I would like to thank Tommy Vapors for the shout out. I highly appreciated that. First thing in the morning, I'm sitting here checking out my YouTube, drinking my cup of coffee. I see a new video from Tommy. Check it out. And he gives me a shout out. Thank you. That meant a lot. You're actually the first person to give me a shout out, so that even makes it better. And yeah, he's a really good character. If you haven't checked him out, I'm going to put a link right below to his page. He has some good videos. He is one of two people that convinced me to start vaping. Him and Indoor Smokers, they are the two that got me into vaping and kind of showed me what the vaping world is like and what kind of opportunities are out there for somebody that's looking to start vaping and to get the basics and to learn the good and the bad and the prices of stuff and what other companies there are available. Because when I first started, I was buying like blue cigs, and I don't have anything against blue cigs, but I thought that was like the only kind of e-cigs out there. Blue cig, halo, stuff like that. No, you actually have mods, and I'm looking at these online going, well, they must build them, because I've never seen them online anywhere. Boy, was I wrong. Well, that was a little bit. Let me back that down a little bit. Whew. That was a long hit. Whew. All right, let's try that again. Much better. Wow, that one snuck up on me, making my eyes water. So, anyways, thank you, Tommy. Anybody else that's into rebuilding, I would like to know what you're doing, what you're using. I'm using your silica wicks, 32 gauge canfall wire, and I might be going up a gauge, but I kind of hear a lot of good stuff about 32, so I think I'm going to stick with that. And I'd like to get a lot more 100% VG and try some of that in this stuff. With the drippers, I heard there's a lot of good stuff with it, so we'll see. This is Black Widow 7293, and always vape.